My dear creative art teacher, you are welcome. We are going to talk about our creative art lessons. And this particular one is focused on Primary 3, Term 1, and Unit 1. Our main topic is making pictures, drawing, and color work. And what is our subheading? Our subheading is drawing and color work. Let's talk about our objectives for this lesson. By the end of this lesson, pupils will be able to draw and paint from imagination to express ideas and feelings. And with this, there is a need for us to express feelings and ideas through imaginative drawing, painting, and other forms of creating pictures using themes. For example, an event that happens on campus regularly, like worship or assembly, a fantasy, a cultural troop dancing. These are ideas that come to mind when we are talking about imaginative drawing. There are a lot of them. You might choose based on your preference. As a teacher, what is your role in teaching this lesson? We are going to pick it one after the other and try to explain what it means for you, the teacher who teach this lesson. First, the teacher will have to discuss issues as stated in the content through questions and answers. You need to interact with your kids or your pupils to get ideas from them as to what activities they can imagine or activities they think they can express that will bring about the way they feel. Second, you, the teacher, will have to guide the pupils to discuss and visualize characters, scenes, objects, and places mentioned in the event or story they tell you. So you have to characterize them and have to try to make them understand and get a fair scene of what their imaginative ideas would be before they try to do this imaginative drawing. There's a need for you, the teacher, to also guide these pupils to role play the characters and visualize the scenes. It also helps them to get a fair idea of what is expected from them. As a teacher, you'd also have to assist your pupils to draw and paint pictures from their imagination, expressing their feelings, ideas, and understanding about the stories they tell or you tell them. There's a need for you to also display people's works for discussion through questioning and answering. That is when the whole activity is done. And this will help them get the feeling that they form part of the discussion, and that will translate into the doing of the work itself. Don't forget, the main topic is making pictures, drawing, and color work. There's a need for you to allow them express themselves, but you have to guide them as they go through this creative process. When all this is done, you're going to acquire some skills and some values. Let's talk about the skills first. One, some of the skills they can acquire is observation. They will learn how to observe, because when they think about the things they are doing, they will have to capture them in their memory before they put them on their various papers or books. Let's talk about the values. One, self-confidence. Two, participation. Three, compassion. All these are key in our creative activities, and we need to help our kids to express all this visually based on what they feel. All this will make sense when we get into the demonstration section. So let's go and get a fair idea of the practical rendition of what we've done right now. I'm ready, so let's go.
Hello. Welcome once again to another practical session. This is our picture making class, and today we are drawing and then coloring to show emotions or ideas. If you have students in your class, probably there are some who find it difficult doing assignments. There are some you find sleeping in the class almost all the time. They may have issues. In order to get their feelings out, you can assign them to a task to draw and paint or shade their feeling or what they do after school or their home situations. Today, I'm going to draw a feeling of sadness or a sad face and then an activity a student undergoes at home, specifically street hawking. So follow me as I draw.
Thank you. I'll define my edges or the outlines with a black marker.
So here we go, we have the feeling of sadness expressed. You can diagnose the problem of your students through art. Just give them a topic that will help you to diagnose their problems, the problems they face in the house or at school. Meet you in another video. Thank you and bye for now.
Hello teacher, you are welcome once again. This particular lesson is a continuation of what has been done in the primary 3, term 1, unit 1 lesson. And the main topic for this one is paper coulé. What does that mean? It simply means cutting out papers to form an image. As simple as that. Let's talk about our objectives. We would use cut out the letters of the alphabet to create pictures. This is our main objective for this particular lesson. For us as teachers who teach creative arts, there's a need for us to give our kids the sense of belongingness. They have to belong to whatever they do. They have to be part of it. Therefore, we have to allow them exhibit whatever they have within them. The objective has been stated clearly. What do we need to do as creative art teachers? First, we have to collect and select a number of magazines, letters of various sizes, shapes, and colors. Two, we have to demonstrate to these kids or pupils how to cut out these letters. But there's a caution here. Because they are kids, there is no need for you to give them sharp objects, because remember, that might hurt them. If you do so, it must be under strict supervision. And that is key. Do not forget as a teacher. Secondly, you will need to guide the pupils to cut out these letter objects and combine two or more of these letters to create a figure, a scene, or a design. And that is all about letter coulé.
Hi, we meet once again. Today we are doing letter coulé. Welcome to today's video. What we're doing is we are picking letters from magazines and then papers. As we can see an N here. No place like home. So we are cutting out letters to form an image. Enjoy with me as we work. I have a D cut out here on a newsprint. Then you'll need an O, two O's for two I's. Then for the whole face, I have you drawn on a newspaper. So I cut out. Which letter will be most appropriate for a nose? I think a T would be. So we cut out a T. And with the help of a brush, we paste on a paper. You have to use contrasting colors. The colors you paste should contrast as compared to your background paper, so that you can see the difference. We have one eye here, and then a second eye. Then a U for the outline of the face. Then we paste. Then cover the head. Another D, the shape of a D. A very beautiful work here we have. We formed with letters from magazines and newspapers a face. This is very interesting, and then you can guide your students to do the same. See you next time in another video.